Hello guys, it's a great day and we are going to be having a great tutorial. And in this tutorial I'm going to be reviewing a lot to you, and I'm going to be reviewing so many things that you don't really know about mixing and mastering. So in this tutorial we are going to be reviewing, I'm going to be telling you on how I mix sound by Fireboy, on how the magic has been done, like how the music came out to be. So today we are going to be having a breakdown on a mixing right here in Lagos, Nigeria. So let's get down. Our mix. So I'm going to be playing down the vocals for you. I'm going to be muting the beat. Put it in back of your mind that this is already mixed. So let me play it so you can get down.
I just realize when I come around, when I play the song, I just realize I'm not just a singer where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar sweet pashito, I'm not fit deny. And when you give me the rhythm and bass jive, away the song is taking me far away. Again, I'm feeling something inside of me. Away, the song is taking me far away. I go crazy when I hear the song.
So you can see, we have a great mixing here. So I am going to be doing this. I can't believe I'm doing this for free, but notwithstanding, it is what I want to do. And it is what the goals of this channel is, reviewing secret. So all I just want from you guys right now is subscribe to my channel, because we really need it. And then I want to tell you guys that I'm back in full, and at least in weeks I'm going to be dropping two videos, two secrets that you guys will be learning from. So I just want you to subscribe to my channel as we dive into this work. So let's turn on the beat and listen to what we have before we get down. Let's go.
I just realize when I come around, when I play the song, I just realize I'm not just a singer where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar sweet pashito, I'm not fit deny. And when you give me the rhythm and bass jive,
this is it, and this is how it sounds, and this is what we are going to be doing. So now what I'm going to be doing right now, after you finish subscribing and commenting on this video, what I'm going to be doing next now is I'm going to be working on our beat. So we are going to be muting our Mr. Channel, we are going to be muting our vocals. So after muting our vocals, first thing I have to do before I mix, I have to treat my beat, because this beat is already compiled and it's already mastered. So now once I have the beat sounds very heavy and I have to work on the beat. Here is what I do. I have to send my beat to a mixed track here, which I have to throw in an EQ, an EQ2. So I'm making use of the EQ to treat my vocals, to treat my beat, like try to like work on it to allow my vocal to breathe. That is the first step you have to take when you are mixing. But hold it in back of your mind, guys. I want you guys to always spend time in recording, like spend much time when you're recording an artist. Make sure you get a very good and clean quality vocals in a good performance. That is number one step you have to take. So now let's treat our beat. So what I have to do here now, I have to treat my beat. So side here, this number four, I have to bring it down at the middle, because most time vocals normally rest in this middle range. So I have to reduce it a little bit. You see the way I duck it down. Now the aspect of the six also, I have to bring it down also a little bit. Then the high frequency, I noticed this beat has a lot of high frequency and is competing with my beat, and I don't really want it to be that, so I have to bring it down this way. Then in also my one and two, which is the bass part, I noticed a lot of bass which I don't really want for now. Maybe during my mastering aspect I will like work on that, but for me to have a space so that I can be able to mix my vocal properly, I have to bring a little dB of it here down in one and two. That is what I did for the beat. So after that, what I want to do next is to get into my mixing of my vocals, and then I'm going to be removing every plugins I've used to make this vocal sound the way it is. So I'm going to be playing the vocal raw for you to listen to before and after of it. So this is how it sound before I have to start mixing.
I have to mute my reverb and delay.
I'm taking off my reverb and delay, so let's go.
I just realize when I come around, when I play the sound, I just realize I'm not just a singer, where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe.
So there is a lot of background noise on which way I when it was recorded, but we worked on that to get rid of that and down to achieve a great sound. So here we go. After the recording of the vocals, after it was sent, first things that comes into my mind was autotune, you know, African music, and I don't want to talk too much. So autotune was my number one stuff I add during my mixing process. So when I add my autotune to it, one of the things I have to like checkmate in this is try to get the key to my vocals. So if you happens that you don't know how to get a keys to your beat, to your song, I think you have to take some damn of my video. I have a lot of video which I taught about how to get, should in case you are new to my channel, I have some video down there. So I don't want to waste much time here. So one of the things I first did after getting my key to this song is D major. This is the key to this Fireboy sound beat. So I have to change to D major. So when I have to change to D major, I have to like add a return speed of my mix. What I mean a return speed here is that return speed means the amount of tuning you want to add to your vocal. That is the meaning of return speed. So I have to add 5 to it, return speed of 5 to it. You can see I have to tune it this way down to 5, return speed of 5, and this is what I did. So I came to this humanizing, and what I actually did around this humanizing is that I want to add a little human feelings to it. And I don't want it to sound so robotic, because this return speed can actually make you sound robotic, and this humanizing can actually refix what the return speed has done, can little change it a little bit to still sound human one, why it still sound very very sweet. So this is at the 2 point I touch. So my input pattern now, it was on soprano. I really don't know the reason why I have to put it on soprano, but seriously, I really don't know why I put it on soprano, but it really really sounds so good on the soprano aspect, and it was so so good. So I came to discover that it was really on soprano, but normally before I used to use the auto tenor and then the low mi, but on this Fireboy's type, in this Fireboy mixing I did, was so sounding so good on the soprano aspect. So that is what I did. You can change it to soprano, auto tenor, or a low mi, any form of feelings you want to give to it. So that is what I did, and this this autotune sounds so great with that. So let's give it a play and see how it sounds with the autotune.
I just realize when I come around, when I play the sound, I just realize I'm not just a singer, where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe.
So you can see the way it sounds with the, with that. So now what I'm adding next to my vocal when I'm done adding an autotune is my EQ. Let's get it. So I have an EQ here, and then what I actually did was to remove the bassy part, to remove some kind of sound I don't really want. And this is an EQ 3 from Fat Filter. I love this EQ very, very much because it is easy to manipulate, and I really, really do love it. I use this most time. So what I did here was to remove the bassy part of my song. So let's get it a play and see how it sounds. So I'm going to be removing, and I'm going to be removing to about 163 hertz. Okay.
Sweet bashi.
So that is how I do sometimes. There are times some producers always advise you move your cut your lows at 150 hertz and so on. Sometimes I even cut more than 163 because I just do what I feel that I feel comfortable doing and gives me great sound. So that is what I do. So do what you feel it is better. You can even cut more than 163 hertz. It is your choice to do it the way you feel like. So that is what I did here. So let's get. So I have to cut to 163.16 hertz.
I'm not just.
So I came to this place, I have some kind of sound I don't really want, and I know it's going to be making my mix to be very muddy, and I don't want it. So let's test it.
And when I play the sound,
so that sound is very annoying, so I have to take it off. So I have to duck it down a little bit. So I came to this place also, I have some kind of sound here that I don't really like. I have to find those things myself, and let me tell you how you can find it. I have to bring it up a little bit this way, then after taking it up a little bit this way, I have to play. You can see it was sounding very annoying.
I just feel like,
so I have to take it down this way, and I have to take it down a little bit. I am not cutting it that much. I'm going to just minusing it 2.95 dB out of it, and it sounds great that way. You see,
when I come around,
so that is what I did here. So we have to come to this aspect of this place. I also have an annoying sound there I used to notice most time when record is. I just have this little secret here that I do, and once I do this, my mix begins to sound very good and very clean. You can see this sound. It's very annoying to when you are using your headset. So I would like everybody watching this video to get a headset or a monitor headset to monitor everything I'm doing, so that we know what we are doing and we can arrive at a safer place. So this is the sound.
I
have to get rid of that because
when I come around, when I play,
because I don't really like that sound and it's sounding so annoying and I don't really want it. So now we come down to this place now, and I have a lot of sound here, another sound here that I don't really like, which sounds this way. You can see it's sounding very noisy, and this one can distort on somebody listening to your music, maybe with headset or with an earpiece, and they get annoyed already. It's already sounding very harsh in their ear. So I'm getting that off. So what I'm trying to say here is that, guys, you have to always calm down when you work on your EQ. You don't have to do much, but you have to like try to get some kind of things. Like EQ can do a lot of things, can change a lot of things in your music. So that is what I did with the EQ, and it's already sounding this way.
I just realized.
So at this moment, I'm going to be playing the beat. I'm going to be playing the instrumental with it, so we know what we are doing. So let's get down.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the sound, I just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they get the.
So that's how it sounds with our EQ. And that is how it's already sounding good. So we added two plugins already. We added our auto-tune and our fad filter EQ. So next thing that we are going to be adding, we are going to be adding our ProGate. I don't know if you know what the ProGate means. This ProG means it's a fad filter plugin, and then we use it to remove some background noise. So I believe you can listen to some kind of background noise at when the mix was going on. There are some noise outside and there are people shouting and so on, because I think there is no isolation on the mic, but it doesn't mean we can still work on it as it is. That is why we are producers. So let's get rid of that at this point in time. So I have my threshold here, so let's play through and see. I'm going to be muting this instrument once more. I'm going to be muting it once more so that we actually get what we are doing, and then we know what we are actually doing. So let's get through now. My threshold.
I just realized.
Can you see?
When I come around, when I play the song, I just realize.
Now the background noise is gone. How many of you can? Okay, let me just bypass it and see. Let's play before and after.
I just realize. When I come around.
Now you can see the background noise. Now let me activate our ProGate.
I just realize. When I come around, when I play the song, I just realize.
Now it's already sounding very, very clean. I know those background noise are gone. Here is what I did. I have to turn down my threshold into minus 38.83 dB. I have to turn it down, 38. You can see this way. That is only what I did. I actually just touched the range here a little bit to just shift a little bit out, but it just a little of it that I have to touch. I didn't touch much of that. So let's play through and see what we did.
I just realized. When I come around, when I play the song, I just realize. I'm not just a singer. When they give the ginger, I give them the vibe.
So you can see the way we have to remove some background noise using our Fad Filter Pro G. It's a nice plugin. You should try and get one. So now what we are going to be adding, now we already have three plugins already, and we are going to be adding something next, and we are going to be adding our compressor. Don't mind me, this is the way I have my own mix put. Maybe you have your own pattern of ways you arrange your plugins, or this is the way I do, and it comes out to be great. And then let's take out how we have to get our compressor in this mix. So let's see what we are going to be doing next.
I just realize. When I come around, when I play the song, I just realize.
Now what I did here is that I have to, in this aspect of this mix, I have to select. I didn't work too much on my EQ. On my compressor. I didn't do too much on my compressor. You can see what I did here was that I have to use a preset on this format for this video. I have to go into preset, go into vocals, and I also have to choose upfront. I have a reason why I have to choose upfront, because I know Fireboy like its vocals to sound very clean and always competing with the beat. He doesn't like his vocals to be very reverbed and very, very hard. He just like it to be very upfront. He like his voice to always represent his sound always. So that is the reason why I have to choose the upfront kind. I have to like have some side chaining here. After you choose the upfront, you can see this side chaining will be done here. You is less for you to adjust and then make some adjustment of the compressor yourself. So this is how it sound with the compressor.
I just realize. When I come around, when I play the song, I just realize.
So now we have something like that, and that's how we have a great sound using our compressor, Fad Filter compressor. So our next plugin we are going to be adding again, I'm going to be adding a second compressor, and this second compressor I am adding out a preset to it, and it's a stock plugin on FL Studio. I know if you're using an FL Studio, you must have this compressor. So what I did here was to work on this compressor myself. I didn't use a preset on this because I want to use presets on that and then come here and work on the compressor myself. So what I did here was to reduce my threshold into minus 21.0 dB. You can see here I have to turn and 21 plus 0 dB, and then I have to add a little bit of attack to rate here like this. I have to add 37.5 attack because this is an Afrobeat. I want my attack to be very hard on my vocals. When the compressor hold it, it will hold it very strong. Then I have to add a little bit of release to it. Wasn't much that much, but it, as long as immediately at the attack have to hold the compressor, the release, it will be releasing it little by little, not that much. When it comes to it, it will release a little. When the attack comes to it, it will release it. I don't know if you understand what I'm trying to explain, but I think I have a video only for compressor down there. If you have an interest in learning about compressing, I have a video down there. So my ratio, I have to add a little bit of ratio to it, which is about 2.0 dB. So when I'm done with that, I have to come to my gain here. I have to gain the volume that I have lost in this aspect. Let me get a play.
I just realize.
So
when I come around, when I play the song, I just realize.
So now I'm going to be.
I'm not just a singer. At, where they give the ginger.
I'm going to be gaming it at 1.8. They are also fine. I'm going to be gaming it in 1.9. I think this is nice. I'm gaming this in 1.9. Let me take it down to 1.8. I think it will be nice. So after that gaining, I have to come to this type. I have to put my type into soft because I really like this aspect of this compressor. I have to put it on soft because I want my vocals to sound very soft in the ears. So I have to put it into this. That is all I did with the compressor, and it sounds this way.
I just realized. When I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like.
So I think we are making improvement, and let's get it to the beat and see how it sound with it. Let's go.
I just realize. When I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like. I'm not just a singer, where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet bashito, I no fit deny. And when you give me the rhythm and bass, child, away.
I think we are doing a great job here, and I believe everyone is following just step by step as we're going. So now let's get down to another plugin that I have to add. I have to add an OTT to this vocal. I love using this OTT on my mix. Sometimes when I don't use OTT, I use Radiator from Samtones plugin, but I think this vocal need the OTT. That's the reason why I have to use the OTT. So most people say this OTT is a compressor. For me, I don't use it as a compressor though. There's a sound I love about this OTT that I love using it. It's a free plugin, you can get it. I just love it. Ever since I got this plugin, I used to use it in my mixing, and it sounding great with the OTT. So what I did with this OTT, there's a particular sound I love here, and let's get to it.
I just realized.
Let me mute my beat, so we know what we are doing. So there's a particular sound I like here.
I just realized.
So I'm going to be turning it very up to in full so that you know what we are adding.
I just realized.
So now there's a sound here, but when you add much of it, it could derive a lot of noise into your vocal, which we don't want. So I'm adding a little bit of it. I'm adding about 4% of it to the vocal. You can see we are trying to mix a professional kind of vocal here, so I'm adding like about 4% of it to it. So let's see.
I just realized. When I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like.
So you can see how it sound. You can see the way it sound with adding a little bit of it. This is the only what I just need, and this is the only reason why I'm adding it to my vocal. So now let's listen once more.
I just realize. When I come around, when I play the song, I just realize.
Wow, this is nice. So this is nice. So another plug, we already have auto tune, EQ, Gate Pro, compressor, compressor 2, and also OTT, which you guys call compressor. So now what I'm going to be adding next is our EQ. I'm going to add another EQ to this vocal. Now there's a reason why I'm adding this EQ to my vocal. So when I'm mixing, I come up with a lot of creativities in my vocal. So I listen very carefully and I know where I'm going. So I really want, there's a sound I really want to achieve, and I keep changing. I keep like trying to get something reasonable for myself. So now this is what I did with this. Let's listen to it with the EQ first.
I just realize when I come around, when I play the sound, I just realize I'm not just a singer.
Now there's something that is going on here. So I'm going to be playing my beat. I'm going to be playing my instrument with it. Let's take a look.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet pashito, I no fit deny.
Now you can see what I did here was to select a preset from here, which is called Vocal Present. This vocal present does is to bring some present into your mix. Now I this place have to be dug down, these two aspects have to be dug down, and this side aspect have to be raised up. Why? To add some airy sound and to add some high frequency to your vocal. That is the reason why I have to use this vocal present preset on my mix. So now what we are going on to next is our Fresh Air. This is a very nice plugin and it does a very great job if you know how to use it. So what I did here was this. Sometimes I add this and sometimes I don't add this. So what I did with this plugin is adding a little kind of air to my vocals. So let's listen to how it sounds with it.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet pashito, I no fit deny.
Now I have to tone down, I have to sidechain this together here so that when I'm raising this up, this also goes in the same directions. So I have to raise this up. I have to sidechain this way, and then I have to like tune it up this way so that when I'm going this way, they'll all go in the same direction. So I have to bring it down to 13, 12. You can see here, and this is 13. So that shows that I am adding air to the bass part of it, and I'm also adding air to the high frequency of it also. That is the low, mid, and the high frequency. That is what this actually does. So let's take a listen.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound.
So that is what I use my Fresh Air to do. That is actually what I derive using this fresh air. Now the next plugin we are going to be add is saturation. I am going to be saturating my vocal. So here we have our saturation plugin. So what I have to do with my saturation here is to go into here and then go into my transformer, choose the one transformer. After I'm done choosing that, I have to like tune this a little bit into 24.0% of it, and then I have to work on this when I listen. So let's go.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like.
Now I have to add a little bit of present to my vocal here, so I have to add about plus 260, like 2.67 dB to it. I have to take it up and add a little bit of it to it. So I came to this place, this band here, this treble. I have to like work. Sometimes I used to duck down my trebles, but in this aspect of my mixing, I actually didn't do anything to the treble, because I discovered that in my first EQ I have to work on my trebles there, so it wasn't reflecting here. So
I just realized when I come around.
Now what I have to do in my mid-range here is docking up my mid-range up a little bit. You can see I just have to add a little bit. It's not up to a dB, it's not even up to a 1 dB, it was about 0.79 dB. It's not up to a dB, just about 0. So when I came to my mid part here, my band, my basic part here, I didn't add anything. Sometimes I normally used to dock it down a little bit or raise it up a little bit, but in this saturation process I didn't actually do this. So you can see sometimes when you watch a video online, you discover that people approach to mixing are different. It's just for you to have the knowledge of what you are doing, then you can do anything. That is it. So let's listen and see.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just realize.
I just like the aspect of that song. So now let's go down to our next plugin that we have to add this plugin. Is a wider. This wider is a very nice plugin and it's a free plugin. I would like you to get it because it is very, 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 very nice. Now, what this wider is doing for me, I use it to make my sound to be full to the speakers. It's just like a stereo expander. I don't know if you understand what I'm trying to say. This is one of my secrets I am revealing to you guys. And this wider is a very, very nice plugin. Now let's listen to these vocals without the wider. I'm going to bypass.
I just realized when I come around.
Now what I'm going to be doing now, I'm going to be turning on the wider now, and I am going to be playing it again in this 27 dB, and you see the difference.
I just realized.
Now at this process, I am going to be widening it now, as in I'm going to be adding more to it. Like, let's play and see what the difference is making. I'm going to play. Okay, let's go there. Okay, let's give it a play now.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just realize I'm not just a singer. Where they give the thing?
Can you feel what I am? Can you feel it? Can you see? Can you feel what I'm trying to achieve here? Now, widening it now is like making it to be full to the speaker. Sometimes I use this plugin. Why did it now is going to look very full to the speakers, and sometimes I use this plugin to during backup time, like, but sometimes I also use it on my main vocal. Like, I want my sound to be very full to the speaker. I want my sound to be very full to the speaker and have a lot of presence in my mix. So now let's say I'm bringing it down this way about 27% of it. 27% of it, and it's sounding this way. I think I like it at this point.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just realize I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet bashito, I no fit deny. And when you give me the rhythm and bass, child.
You can see we are already achieving something very, very great, and that is one of the secrets I'm putting down for you guys. Try and get this plugin, and if you don't have, you can drop it at the comment section for me. I'm going to be sending it down to anybody who requested for it. That is it. So what we are going to be going into next is another aspect of our mix, and that we are going to be going down to delay and reverb. Then after that we talk about mastering in our other videos coming. So let's dive into our delay. So here we are adding the delay to our vocal now. So let's take a listen to what we have done so far and see.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just realize I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet bashito, I no fit deny. Me the rhythm and bass, child. Away, away, the song is taking me far away.
So when we talk about our aspect of our delay, what I actually did here was turning on the preset of my delay. Then I have to sidechain my lead vocal to my delay to an empty track, and I have to rename this into delay. So after I'm done with the renaming, I have to just give it any kind of color I just feel like, and then load the delay into this. Should, in case you haven't watched my video of delay process, I have a video down below that talks about delay, only delay, and you can go there and just learn a lot of lessons from there, and I believe that you are going to achieve a lot of things watching those videos. So you should go down there and watch the video before you come back to the aspect of this place, so that you know how to add delay to it. Now what I'm going to do here is that, first of all, one of the things I have to do is to just go to my timing and then add 8 step to it. After adding 8 step to it, I have to turn down the volume of my dry aspect all the way to 0. Then the cut aspect of my cut, I have to like cut it a little bit, not that much, just a little bit. You can cut yours as much as you want, but I just cut a little bit because of the pattern of the song I am doing. Now what we are going to do next is to like play through and see how our delay sound with our, I know this is going to sound so disturbing in your ears, but
I just realized when I come around, when I come around, I'm not just a singer.
So you can see, oh, this is so hard. Okay. This is so hard on our ears, you know. The feedback was so, it was too much, but we are going to fix that. That is the reason why we are producers. So now what we are going to do next now is, after adding our delay to our vocal here, what I'm going to do next is to add a fruit limiter. I'm going to turn it on. I have to sidechain this. This is the reason why I'm referring you down to my other videos, because I don't want to go deep into sidechaining in this video, because it's going to take us so much long time to finish up this video. So you can try and watch those videos, the next video at the bottom of this video, you will learn a lot on adding delay and other stuff. So now what I did here was to sidechain. When I sidechain, I just have to like click on video, on the vocal that I just sidechain it to the main lead vocal. You can see here,
I just realized when I come around, when I play the sound, I just realize.
So when I listen through, I will be like, the threshold, I'm going to be turning it, you can see, turning it to compress and to like, what I'm trying to do here is that I'm trying to like make my delay to only sound when my voice, when the voice of Fireboy rest. That is what I'm trying to do here. When he rests, delay will continue, and when he starts singing, delay will stop. That is exactly what I'm trying to achieve in this aspect, because I don't want the delay to be competing, to be fighting with his voice. That is exactly what we are trying to achieve on this aspect.
I just realized when I come around, when I come around, I just realize I'm not just a singer. Where they give
it down,
I give them the vibe. The sun,
you can see what I'm trying to do here. You can see what I'm trying to do. So once I pause the vocal, you see the way it continues. And now let's
I just realize when I come around, when I play the sound, I just realize I'm not just alive.
Now I feel like my ratio is best at this point in time, and that's only what I did with the fruity limiter, and it's a nice plugin and I love it a lot. So that is what I did with it. Now let's talk about what I did added next to my delay. I added an EQ to it. Why did I add this EQ to it? Was to, I want to like give it a change to the change of sound to my delay feedback. I don't want it to sound exactly the way my vocal is sounding. So I have to go to a preset here. I selected the radio preset, and because I feel that it's going to match up with this vocal a lot. So when I selected the radio preset,
I just realized when I come around, when I play the sound, I just realize I'm not just a singer. When they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet bashita, I'm not
you can see the way our delay is already sounding very, very clean and very, very good. Guys, this is a secret. You should take it. So now what we are going to do next is I'm going to like play my vocals now in full, and then I treat my delay into a perfect sounding volume, because this is what mixing is.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the sound, I just feel like
you can see I'm going to be bringing it down a little bit. I'm going to be bringing it down to get a perfect duration for where I'm getting it from. So now
I just realized when I come around, when I play the sound, I just feel like I'm not just a singer, where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe.
Wow. So this is the aspect I have comes, and this is the aspect I have put my delay on, because I feel that the delay is best at this spot, and I feel that it is nice at this spot. So what I am going to be doing next is that I'm going to be adding our reverb to this vocal this time around. But before then, I would like everybody who is watching this video to take this video down to the end, because there's a lot that will be going on. So now let's try to talk about our reverb aspect. Let's get down to adding of our reverb to our vocal. So it's the same procedure in which we added our delay to our vocal. So what we am going to do now, we are going to be sidechaining in the same form. We are going to be connecting. So now what we are going to be doing here is that after sidechaining my verb to my vocal, I have to go into it. Let me get rid of this. And I am using, this is the reverb I'm using. Sometimes I try a lot of reverb on this, but I come to discover that this reverb is best for this sound. So you mustn't rely on the Valhalla vintage verb alone. You can also try many kind of verb, many kind of reverb on your mix, because every song comes with different kind of styles and different kind of reverb that will match up to it. So in this Fireboy sound, what I actually used was the Valhalla vintage verb. After trying other verb, I come to discover that this is best for this, and this is what we agreed, and then we use on this. So let's get right into it and see what I actually did. So I'm going to be reviewing a secret to you guys, and this is it. What I actually did here was that I don't actually just throw up my reverb to my vocal. What I do is that I have to calculate my reverb. So guys, you have to calculate your reverb. It is very, very essential when you calculate your reverb. So because when you just throw reverb into your vocals, it actually distorts your mix and is going to have a little bad effect on your mixing. So let's check how I have to calculate my reverb. So if I'm calculating my reverb, this is what I do. I have to calculate 60,000 divide by the BPM of my song, which is 94. You can see 94 divide by the bar of my song. So in this music, I'm using 8 bars, so I am going to divide it by 8, and you can see it gave me 79.78. so now when I come to this place, now I have to add my pre-delay. I have to type it, I have to set it, or you can just readjust it from this aspect, tune it and set it to 79.78 ms. So this is how you can calculate your reverb, guys, and it is very, very essential you calculate it that way, and it works. So after adding my reverb to this, I have to calculate my reverb. After getting my pre-delay, I have to add a smooth plate to it. After adding a smooth plate to it, what I did next is taking my mix all the way up in full to 100%, and then my decay, I have to set my decay into 1.9. I just have to like drag it that way, like how long my delay have to take, and you know how it's going to expand in the music into the speakers and so on. So let's give it a play and see how it sound with it, and see.
I just realized this is turn off.
I'm going to turn it on now. So let's get down and play.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them.
So you can see the way it sounds, it's sounding so wide, and this is not what we want, and this is the reason why we are producers. So this is what I did with my Valhalla Vintage Vibe. This is the only thing I did with it. So after doing this, I have to close, and what I did next was still adding an EQ to the mix. So you can see the way EQ is very, very essential. So I add an EQ to it. So adding an EQ to it, I have to take away the low part and the high aspect of it. This is what I did. I have to take down the both part of it. Let's play and see.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like I'm not just a singer.
So I'm going to be doing something quick here because of my CPU. I'm going to be doing this right now. Okay, now I'm doing this. So now I think my CPU is having much plugins on it already. So now let's get down and do this now. So let's get down and do this now. Let's bring back my EQ and then play and see how it sound with the EQ on it.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe.
Now this is not how we want our reverb to sound, because there's a lot of presence of reverb. That is the reason why I have to sidechain so that I can have control over my reverb. So we are going to be playing through, and then we are going to be turning down the reverb volume. Let's go.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet bashito, I no fit deny. And when you give me the rhythm and bass, child,
so guys, what did you learn so far? Drop it at the comment box, because I'm going to be coming up with back to back a lot of mixing tutorial in different kind of pattern, in different kind of style of music. I'm going to be coming with it. So now you can see that we have a great sound already, and then it's a very, very nice sound. So what we are going to be doing next is I'm going to be playing this song all through so that we can listen to it, and then we can drop our comment concerning this. Or if you have any difficulties about this song, about this mix, you can drop at the comment section, because I'm full time back to the studio where we are going to be learning a lot, and I'm going to be treating a lot about vocals, mixing different kind of vocals, Omale, Timaya, Davido, and so on, Ashake. I'm going to be coming up with so many voice. And then if you want a preset for this Fireboy sound, I am going to be giving out the preset. Seriously, I mean it, for free for my subscribers. So all I want you to do is to subscribe to my channel. I want us to hit 1k. This is one of my goals right now. So like, let's just hit 1k, and I'll appreciate. Thanks to everyone who have subscribed to me. Love you all. Let's listen to our mix and see how it sound, and enjoy. Let's go.
I just realized when I come around, when I play the song, I just feel like I'm not just a singer. Where they give the ginger, I give them the vibe. The sound of the guitar, sweet bashito, I no fit deny. And when you give me the rhythm and bass, child, away, away, the song is taking me far away. Again, again, I'm feeling something inside of me. Away, away, the song is taking me far away. I go crazy when I hear the sound. When I hear the sound now, when I hear the sound, when I hear the sound now, oh nah. I don't want to die, I just wanna sing to the rhythm and dance, baby, one more time. I just want the guests
go crazy, I go crazy. When I hear it,
it's you. Thank you.